welcome to the every participant to this special webinar on entitled and machine learning approaches for forecasting and planning. This time, I'm thanks to our college trust and our humble principal Dr. A. Shivakumar sir and my HOD, and also the support partners. I am thankful Mr. James Ramesh and Kumar Swami and S. Kamalish. So now I'm going to give an address about our presenter and specialist. He has completed his BTech IT in Coimbatore, and he has experience of 4 years in embedded system design, power electronic design, and IoT applications. Work with the different applications, convert designs, robotic applications, and cloud interfaces for IoT applications. Take us strength in implementation of projects and conducting workshops in various universities. And he has the technical skills of programming language like MATLAB, embedded C, Python, and PC design, and hardware of AMR, DSTIC, Arduino, Raspberry Pi, and robotic applications. Working experience in firmware developer, power electronic design, IoT application developer, and robotic design. And currently, the field of working in IoT for electrical application, A on robotics, and machine learning for energy saving. Behalf of every participants and our department and college, I'm addressing our addressing and welcoming our presenter. So sir, our presentation is yours. Hello, sir. Sir, you can start now, sir. The session is yours, sir.
Yeah.
Hello.
Good morning.
Yeah.
So, before we go into the session, once to tell the audio of my, it's audio, it's correctly audible for everyone. Put the chat message in chat box, then we will start the chat.
Okay, just a minute, sir. Any queries and any technical issues you're facing, just ping in the chat box. And end of the session, we'll give a feedback form you have to submit, supposed to submit that. Based on that only, we'll generate the e-certificate. So all of you, please respond. And more important thing, you just mute your microphone and the video. Don't present anything in the mid. If you have any doubt, just note it and ping in the chat box. Thank you so much.
Okay. So, good morning, Ananda. So first of all, I like to give thanks to college and assistant professors and then coordinators and HOD of the respected department. Okay, so thank you for this conducting webinar on machine learning approach for forecasting and planning. Okay, so in this session we are going to see about, after collecting a data from the different type of sensors, okay, so what we will do with machine learning. Okay, so this is the process we are going to see. Okay, before we enter into the session, I like to give the introduction to machine learning. Okay, what is machine learning and what are the types of machine learning and where we are using in different type of domains. Okay, so I like to introduce myself. My name is Kamalesh and I am from Pantex Solution. Sir already introduce about me. Okay, let me enter into the session. Okay, so in this session we are going to see about this is the content like introduction, application, machine learning types, and like Python libraries, process, how we are doing step-by-step process, and if we have a time we will see about problems and the ML algorithms. Okay, so first we are into the introduction. Okay, introduction is nothing but so what is machine learning? Okay, so each and every presentation this question is there. Okay, what is machine learning? Okay, so simply we want to tell about machine learning means we take it as a example as a human being. Okay, so human being will learn from past data. Okay, so like for example, if you take as a human being, you are going in a roadside. Okay, so roadside based on the in roadside we have different type of vehicles like lorries, buses and trucks. Okay, like that we have a different type of vehicles. Okay, so based on the sound we can predict what type of vehicles. Okay, how you are learn this one means from childhood onwards you are learning based upon the sound, that is learning from past data. Okay, so like that if you want to train one machine, okay, so we need to give some past data. Okay, so that is the important thing. If you want to train the machine, you need to give some past data. Okay, so where we are getting the past data? Okay, so past data we can get from like social medias like Twitter or any Facebook or Instagram, or if you are more into IoT, that is Internet of Things, we have some sensors. Okay, some sensors will be available in like humidity sensor or temperature sensor or pressure level sensor. Okay, this will be in our environment, we will place it in our environment, and then we will collect some data about the climate condition, then we will take store the data into the one Excel sheet. After we are saving those data into the Excel sheet, we will train the machine. Okay, so like this only we are getting the past data. Okay, whether it's in the structured form or not an unstructured form. Okay, so but we need some data to train the algorithm. Okay, so why we are using machine learning and deep learning means everybody will hear about the word AI, that is artificial intelligence. Okay, so artificial intelligence is nothing but it's a subset of machine learning and deep learning. Okay, so if you are no machine learning or deep learning, AI is looking like a small thing. Okay, so if you are not know about machine learning or deep learning, AI is looking huge. Okay, so that is what here we are using machine learning or deep learning. Okay, so first of all you need to know about what is machine learning and what is deep learning. Okay, because everybody will hear these two words. Okay, what is machine learning and what is deep learning? Okay, so both are common only. We are giving a past data, that is we are giving a data to the algorithm. Algorithm will be learned from those data, then it will be give the prediction result. Okay, so this is the general definition for both machine learning and deep learning. But here data is changing. Okay, for example, if you take an machine learning, we have a data is small amount. Okay, small amount means like 15 MB or 13 MB, or we have a small amount of data to train the algorithm. Okay, so if you increase the data size of the machine learning algorithm, if you increase the data size to train the machine learning algorithm, machine learning will not give the accuracy result perfectly. Okay, so that's why the deep learning will come here. Okay, so if you are giving more number of data to the deep learning type of algorithm, it will be give the increase the accuracy result. Okay, so for example, I will give some object photos like bottle, water can, and then pen, pencil, like that. I am having some set of photos. Okay, so I am giving those photos to the other, that is training the, using those photos I am training the algorithm. Then I will, in front of camera, if I show anything like it's a pencil or pen, means it will be give the output whether it's a pencil or pen. Okay, so this is comes under both deep learning and machine learning. But if it is a data is huge, means you need to use deep learning type of algorithm. Okay, if your data set is less amount, means you need to use machine learning type of algorithm. Okay, so simply we want to tell about difference between machine learning and deep learning is nothing but in 1990s or 1980s machine learning algorithm is popular. Why? Means we don't have data. Okay, we don't have that amount of data, like a big data we don't have. Okay, but if you take an 20th century, we have a 20 or 21st century, we have a more data, that is each and every day we are collecting a data from like Facebook or TikTok or in somewhere. Okay, so each and every day we have a billion amount of GBs will be there. Okay, data is producing. So now its machine learning will be changed into as a deep learning. Okay, so this is the main difference between machine learning and deep learning. Okay, so next we will move on to highlight of machine learning. Okay, so here why I am using machine learning. Okay, it's in left corner you have some traditional programming. Okay, like you are giving x equal to 1 or x equal to 2, and then you are giving some rules. Okay, based on that rules it will be give the output. Okay, so this is an this is a traditional programming. But if you take a machine learning program, you are giving a data and output. Okay, so data is nothing but some of the questions. For that questions you will be give the answer also. Okay, so machine will be think based on the past questions. Okay, that is the highlights of machine learning. Okay, so terminology, if you want to develop on machine learning project, you need to use data set and futures and model. About this I will tell you. Okay, that what is data, what is futures, and what is model. Okay, so then application, where we are using real time applications. Okay, so real time applications like Netflix. Okay, so everybody will know about Netflix. Okay, so for example, in Netflix we have a search option like different. For example, I need not only you need to search for like a movie name. Okay, if you search for I need a romantic movie, like that, if you search means it will be give the romantic based type of movie. Okay, so I need a science fiction movie. Okay, like that, if you search it in search bar, means it will be give the search movie. So this one all comes under machine learning only. Okay, so the next one is Facebook. Everybody will know. Okay, if you are taking a photograph, group photograph, and then you are try to post in your account, okay, then it will be automatically give the suggestions who I want to tag. Okay, so auto friend tagging. Okay, so this is comes under deep learning. Okay, deep learning type of algorithms. Okay, then after that Google Pay or phone pay or PayPal. Okay, so it's also based on machine learning only. For example, if you are transferring one amount to some person, then you will be get a reference card or some offer card. Okay, so this and all comes under machine learning only. According to the transaction amount wise, they will give some offers card. Okay, so this and all comes under comes under machine learning. Okay, so in real time we can use like Amazon, FIFA games, and Uber Eats. Okay, Uber Eats fully like Uber Eats, Zomato. For example, if you take a Zomato like food means if you want to order any food, you will enter into the your application, then if you search for any food, and then if you exit the application, then automatically some 10 minutes or 20 minutes it will be give the automatic notification, your food is waiting for you. Okay, so please order it now, like that it will be give some notification. Okay, so this notification and all based on machine learning things only. Okay, so this and all we are taking. Then types of machine learning. Okay, so what are the types available in machine learning? Okay, how we can classify those types. Okay, first of all, in machine learning we have totally three types. Okay, supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Okay, supervised learning is nothing but if you have a data set. Okay, so here one thing I want to tell you, data set is nothing but it's in the form of text file or CSV file or Excel file. Okay, or JSON file. Okay, so this is the data set. Okay, the don't confuse, data is some other thing. Data is nothing but it's in the form of Excel or CSV or text file, anything. Okay, so here we have a supervised learning. Okay, supervised learning is nothing but we are giving a data with the output. Okay, for example, I am taking an example of credit card fraud detection. Okay, so credit card fraud detection means in name itself we need to find whether it's a fraud user or not a fraud user. Okay, so if I download the data set of credit card fraud user, I am having an data, that is number of transaction, from which time to which time that user will be transacted, and then at last I have a label file. That label file is called as a output file. That is, if it is a, if I am having a zero, it's zero is equal, zero is means it's a not a fraud user, one means it's a fraud user. Okay, so like that I will classified. Okay, that is called supervised learning. We have an input and we have an output. Okay, if you unsupervised learning means nothing but we have only an input. That is, it's a same example we can take. Okay, credit card fraud example. In this, if we have an data, there is no label column. Okay, if it is a fraud user, it's a not a fraud user like that. There is no label column. That is unsupervised learning. Reinforcement learning is it's like a AI. Okay, based on your environment, it will be at. Okay, so for example, it's like a child. Okay, so child first, if with a child, any child will be see the candle. Okay, so it will the child will not know whether it's a heat we have or not. Okay, then it will be after it's touching only, it will be feel it, or it's heating. Okay, so then next time it won't touch. Okay, like that. Learn from errors. That is called reinforcement learning. Then supervised learning. So here you can see the in the slide we have a known data and response data. Okay, so that is I am giving some data to the algorithm. Okay, that during giving time itself I am tell to the algorithm this is the apple. Okay, that is called supervised learning. If I give an any banana, I will tell to the model this is the banana. Okay, like that I am giving a data and output. Okay, what is that one? And then after that I am giving a new input data, mean it will be give the output it's an apple. Okay, that is called supervised learning. If it is unsupervised learning, I am giving only a known data, but I am not give the data it's an apple. Okay, automatically model will be understand and then change it into the cluster. Okay, so that is the thing of model unsupervised learning. Okay, so in supervised learning we have two types. One is classification and regression. Okay, so classification is nothing but we need to predict an output yes or no, or true or false. Okay, or fraud user or not a fraud user. Okay, so that is called classification, just classifying into two or three clusters. Okay, but regression is different. Okay, regression will be continuous value. Okay, for example, if you take our weather. Okay, today we have a weather, today we have an so sunny. Okay, next day it will be changed as an rainy. Our temperature will be, today temperature is somewhat minimum and next day temperature will be increased. Okay, like that we can't predict exactly this is the output, we can't predict. Okay, so it's some continuous value, that is called regression type. Okay, so in this session, today's session, we are going to teach about regression only. Okay, then classification. So here you can see the simple example. Here we got good or bad, we need to predict which side is that one. If I giving an input data 20, 15, we model want to predict which side is this one, whether it's a good or bad, that is the output. Okay, if it is a regression type, it need to predict, if I give an input data, you need to predict an independent and dependent variable. Okay, that is the output of regression type. Okay, so in supervised learning we have different type of algorithms like nearest neighbor, naive bayes, decision tree, linear regression, support vector missing, and SVM, neural network. Okay, so these are the algorithms will be applicable for both classification and regression. Okay, so if you want to use decision tree regression, it will be available in decision tree regression, or if you want to use decision tree classification, it will be available in sklearn package. Okay, then unsupervised learning, I already told to you, without data. So here I am giving some data, but that data I am not telling to the model if it is like this means it's a circle, if it is like this means it is a triangle, like that I am not telling anything. Okay, it's just I am giving a data. Based on those data, each data have some different attributes. Okay, based on the attribute, it will be divided into three types, that is three clusters. That is called unsupervised learning. Okay, in unsupervised learning we have a two type, that is clustering and association. Clustering and association is nothing but we need to if you want to predict, for example, in real time we take a COVID-19. Okay, so nowadays the spreading of COVID-19 is increased. Okay, so if you want to predict according to the area wise how much cases are attacked, okay, like that, we need, you need to predict, means you need to use clustering type of algorithms, okay? It will be split the data and give the result, okay? Clustering type of data. Then association is nothing but recommendation, okay? In Flipkart or Amazon, if you're searching for any mobile, it will be give the some of the suggestions in below of the website, okay? So like that, it will be give the association is the one type of learning. It will be given the suggestions, okay? For example, you can here, you can see the customer one and customer two. Customer one buying a bread, milk, fruit, wheat, like this, and then customer two also buying bread, milk, rice, butter, okay? So within this, customer one, customer two, similarity is, if the customer one customer buy a milk, definitely they are buying a bread, okay? So like this, customer one, customer two is there, okay? Then automatically give the suggestions for, if the customer three buy a bread, automatically give the milk as a suggestion, okay? That is called a recommendation system, like movie recommendation system, or in Flipkart some recommendation systems are there, okay? That is the comes under association learning. Then unsupervised learning have totally two type of algorithm. One is k-means clustering and another one is association clustering, okay? Then reinforcement learning, it's learned by, it's from its error only, okay? That is based on, it's like a Mario game, okay? So if you are playing a Mario game according to the obstacles, okay, it will be if you are training those Mario game to the algorithm, means it will be learned from according to your playing, and then it will be try to play automatically, okay? That is called reinforcement learning. For reinforcement learning, we have a Q learning and temporal difference and deep adversarial network, okay? These are the three algorithms for reinforcement learning. Today we are going to see about supervised learning regression type, okay? In we have a in machine learning, we got three type. One is supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Today we are going to see in supervised learning regression type, okay? So for that, I need to use some library files like pandas, numpy, matplotlib, cbarn, sklearn, and nlp, okay? So nlp, today I'm not going to in this session I'm not using, but I will use pandas, numpy, matplotlib, cbarn, and sklearn, okay? So about this all library files, in technical session I will explain to you, okay? Then process of machine learning, like data collection, I will explain it in detail using paint, okay? So I am here opening a paint, okay? So I will show the data set first of all, then you will be, so this is our data set, okay? So I will tell you the data set description. So I am collecting a data set from Kaggle website, okay? So weather forecasting, like mean, I have a data set of mean temperature, humidity, and wind speed and mean pressure, okay? This data set is collected from January 2013 to April 2017 about city of Delhi, okay, in India. We have totally four parameters: mean temperature, humidity temperature, wind speed, and mean pressure value, okay? So in using these data set, I will teach you how we can apply a regression type of algorithm in supervised learning, okay? So this is our data set. See here, it's in the form of Excel sheet only, okay? So here we have a date and mean temperature, humidity, wind temperature, sorry, wind speed and mean pressure, okay? So I need to predict the output of mean temperature, okay? So this is what I need to tell you. So simply I want to explain about the machine learning processes. First I will collect the data set, okay? So data set, now I show it to you. First I will collect the data set. After collecting a data set, I will do some steps like pre-processing or data cleaning or data wrangling, okay, and removing null values and removing some unwanted columns or rows, like that I will do in first step, okay? So after that I will move for next step. That second step is nothing but plotting a graphs, okay? Plotting graph means that is data analysis part, that is exploratory data analysis part, okay? So we are just using some mean temperature or any other axis, any other column we will take, and we will display some graphs, okay? That is the second step, okay? So after this I will be move on to third step, that is classification, okay? Classification is nothing but dividing the data set into two type, okay? One is trained data, another one is test data. For example, if I have a 1000 days weather report, 1000 days weather report. I will divide this data set into two type. One is train data, another one is test data. Okay, so one is train data, one is train data, another one is test data. Okay, so sorry about this, I don't have my laptop, touch laptop is not working, so I'm using mouse only I'm drawing. Okay, so train and test. Okay, so train is nothing but we need to train the model, that is what type of algorithm we are using, we need to train the model. Okay, so here I am using dividing my data set into two type, one is train data, another one is test data. Okay, so 80% of data will be move on to train and 20% of data will be move on to test. Okay, so using these 80% of data I will train the model. Okay, after I am training the model, I will give the test data to the model. Okay, so for this test data, algorithm will be give the output, how much mean temperature in at the date of 2017 and 2018, and some data input value I am giving, it will be give the output according to the previously learned from train data. Okay, so this is what I want to tell you about simple architecture of machine learning. Like this only I will do it in my Jupyter notebook. Okay, so let me move on to the technical session. I hope everybody will understood about what I am telling about machine learning and the types of machine learning and application. Then we will move on to real time. Okay, so here I am using this Jupyter notebook. So Jupyter notebook is nothing but to analyzing data science or to machine learning ideally. Okay, so here I already opened Jupyter notebook. So here only I need to, here you can see I'm having a data set. Okay, that is daily Delhi climate test data and daily Delhi climate train data. Okay, so based on this data set I will train the algorithm. Okay, so here I'm having a data set. If I want, means I will open it in so see again. So this is my data set. I already downloaded from Kaggle website. Link also in presentation I display to you, link of that data set. Okay, so just I'm having a data set. Using this data set, I will train the regression type of algorithm and check the output whether it's predicted correctly or not. Okay, so for that purpose, I'm creating a new Python 3 file. Okay, so new Python 3 file. New Python 3 file is nothing but Jupyter notebook file. Okay, so here you can see untitled IBMP file, and in the place itself I am having a data set. Okay, so I am having a both, that is untitled Python file and then my data set. Okay, so first of all I will zoom. Okay, so next, what is the thing is, I want to read my data set. Okay, so to read the data set, I need to use some basic packages, that is basic library files. Basic libraries. Okay, so this is the Python libraries. I already told to you, we need to use some packages like pandas. Okay, pandas as pd. I am calling a pandas simply, short form PD. Okay, so pandas is nothing but to read the input data. Okay, so that is the use of pandas. Okay, so here I am having a data set of Excel sheet. So I need to read this Excel sheet to my coding file. So I am using a pandas. Okay, then import NumPy. Okay, NumPy is nothing but numerical Python. It's like an array. Okay, so here I am using NumPy as np, and then import some plotting package. Okay, matplotlib. So matplotlib is the package to plot the graphs. Okay, Python plotting. Okay, so as PLT. Okay, so to plot a graph. Okay, so this is the package I am using for my this program for simple linear regression. Okay, Matplotlib inline. Okay, so I am running the shell. So if I just click the shell, and if you click the run button, automatically it will run. Okay, now the package, all what I have given, all are imported. Now I want to read my data set. Okay, so I'm creating one variable. In this variable, using pandas, I already told to you, pandas is to read the CSV file. Okay, so that is to read the input data. So pd.read CSV, then I need to call my data set. Okay, that is, we have a data set of two. One is train data set. Okay, first I will read the train data set. Okay, so after I am reading, I just using ds dot head. Okay, head is the function to plot the graph. Sorry, so here, see here, what I am data available in my CSV file, that will be readed using pandas. Then I am displaying using head function. Head is the function to display first five. Okay, so first five, to display first five. So here you can see, but in DS we have all the data of Delhi climate train. Okay, so but I am displaying only first five. Then next I will be move on to read my next one, that is read my train data. Okay, so sorry, read my test data. For that purpose I am using DDS, that is test data is equal to pd dot read underscore csv, and then I am calling it again test data. Okay, so tds install. If I check tds dot head, is displaying first five. Okay, so if you want to check the length, you can use length, len, length function, that is inbuilt function in Python. Using tds you can check the, here you can see totally I have 114 rows of data I'm having. Okay, that is called that is a test data. Okay, so if you're using a ds, this is my train data, that is 1462 data is available in my tds. Okay, so here I have a data of test and train. Okay, so simply what I want to do means I need to concatenate, sorry, I need to append both data. Okay, so here what I am doing means I am having a two different data set. So with the two different data set, I am appending each other. Okay, that is appending train data and test data. Okay, because I don't need like this separate, I'm just want to make appending. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, so next what I will do means ds equal to, simply I'm creating a one variable. In this variable I am appending my what is that, sorry, wait a minute, append my, that is tds, that is test data. Okay, and then ignore index value equal to true, because each and every data frame have index value. Okay, so we don't need about we don't want to bother about the index value. So just I am giving yeah, index value, just I am ignoring index, then displaying the cell. Okay, so if I run the cell, all the data, that is all the tds data will be appended to ds. Then after I can save it in ds, then I am using a save is the function to check how many rows and columns. So totally I have 1576 rows and 5 columns. Okay, so this is what I need to do for appending. Okay, so then we will do some plotting. Okay, so for example, wait a minute, before plotting I need to convert my data into array value. So for that purpose I am taking only whatever you need, you can take. I am taking a mean temperature. If you want to write for humidity, you can take humidity row, but I am here I am taking a mean temperature row. Okay, then after that So here if I print the data, only mean temperature will be stored in DS. Okay, so what I will do means I will convert my DS into an array type. Okay, so I already told to you, if you want to use array value, you can use numpy. Okay, so array type, array, then DS, and converting into the array and DS and reshaping the data, that is just using DS dot reshape, that is converting my columns and rows, reshaping -1, 1. Okay, so then after printing, see here, so now it's reshaped. Then next, what I want to do means I need to just visualize the data set. Okay, so now we will move on to visualizing part. Okay, visualizing the data set. Okay, just visualizing the data set like using plot. Okay, so I will tell you, we save it in plot plot. Matplotlib will be save it in plt. Then using plot function, I am displaying the DS. Okay, so see here, so this is my mean temperature data. Okay, so how it's predicting each and every day. Okay, so like this only it's predicting. Okay, this is each and every thing will be from data only. Okay, based on the data it's showing the result. Okay, so this is for only mean temperature. So if you want, means you can take it for, if you want to see for humidity, you just copy the humidity and paste it here, humidity, then run it again and again up until this cell, then you will be graph will be show for humidity. Okay, so next thing, next we will train the algorithm, because our main aim is that one only. Okay, we are training the algorithm and testing the prediction value. Okay, how much it's working, how it's working my algorithm. Okay, so for that I need to do some pre-processing, like standardization. Okay, standardization is nothing but we need to convert our data into same data type. Okay, that is the standardization. So just we need to use standardization. Standardization is here, I'm importing a standardization from sklearn. Okay, so sklearn is the package every machine learning pre-processing or model selection, or you want to import algorithm like random forest, navy bias, svm, or logistic regression, or linear regression, or k-means clusters, whatever you need to use sklearn package. So it's only purely for doing machine learning projects. Okay, so in this sklearn I am doing pre-processing. So I want to import pre-processing, then after that I need to use minimax scalar. Okay, minimax scalar is nothing but we need to redefine our data values into starting and ending as a equal. Okay, so minimax scalar I am importing, then I am saving the scalar function into one variable. Okay, scalar function into one variable. After that I am passing my data. Okay, so scalar dot fit transform. Okay, so to transform my all the data into the minimax scalar function, and then after that I am printing the DS. Okay, so this is the what, so you see here, this is my before output, that is we have a 10 point something and 7 point something and 32 point something. Okay, so like this we have a float value, that is we have more, it will take more number of space. Okay, like this if you train this. So I am converting my all the data into the after decimal. Okay, so this is called standardization. Okay, so next, what is the thing I want to do means you can use, next I already told to you, we need to divide our data set into two type, one is train data and another one is test data. Okay, so that is splitting the train and test. Okay, splitting the data into two types, that is train and test. Okay, so For that purpose, I am just creating one variable, that is train. In train, I am displaying DS. I'm calling a DS. DS is nothing but I'm doing slicing here. Okay, slicing is nothing but I'm giving a starting value and ending value. Okay, that is 80% of data. Okay, that is 80% of data. I'm save it in train. Okay, then next balance 20% will be save it in test. Okay, so here I am taking a balance test data, that is what is the end value of here. You need to, from the end value, you need to take the all the data. Okay, so that is the testing. From, I am not giving anything here, so it automatically take it as a at the end default value. Okay, that is called 20% of data. Okay, so if you check the train and test, train dot save, okay, and then test dot save, okay, so you will be get an output of how many rows and columns in this. See here, so totally I am having 1462 up to 1462 data will be available in train data, and next time displaying a test step, in test step 114 is there. Okay, so next what is the thing I will do, means I will create one function. In those function I will train according to the previous value and today's value, that is previous mean temperature and today's mean temperature. Okay, so like that I will create one data. Okay, that create one function. So those function I already typed, I'm just copying and paste it in those value. Okay, so here you can see I'm created one function. In this function I'm passing two parameter, that is data set and then look back. So why I am doing this function is like training data into training a data according to previous value and today's value, that is current value. Okay, so like that I am training. Okay, that is the use of this function. Okay, so I'm just running the function, then it's rendered. Okay, next we'll be move on to passing the parameter. Okay, so I'm creating here look back, so this is random thing only. Look back is nothing but it's a random. I'm creating one look back. Okay, equal to 1. Here you can give whatever you need. Okay, that's not a problem. Then here I am passing a two variable, that is x train comma y train. Okay, so two, that is x train is we have a data of mean temperature, and in y train we have a output in mean temperature of mean temperature, that is x train and y train. Okay, so I am calling my get data function. In this function I am passing the train value, then look back also. Okay, so look back also, this is the why I am doing like this, means I am having only a train data, I need to find my output of the train data. So for that purpose I am creating this function, and then I am passing those parameter to those these two parameter this function, and then it will be find the train data and train data output. Like same thing only I need to do for test data. Okay, just copying and then pasting. Okay, so here I will use, instead of x train and y train, x test and y test. Okay, so here instead of train I will pass test data. Okay, so this is the look back method working. And then if I print the, if I see the x train and x test, you will get an output. Okay, that is x train and then y train. Okay, so you will be get an output of, see here, so this is the starting value, this is the ending value. So ending value will be taken to y train. Okay, so like this starting value and ending value will be stored in X train. The ending data will be stored in Y train. Okay, so like this, it will be learned according to the previous data and today's data. Okay, so then after that, let's we come into the end of this session. Like, just we need to train the algorithm. Okay, train the algorithm. Okay, so here I'm using the algorithm like from sklearn dot ensemble type of algorithm. In ensemble type of algorithm, I'm importing an random forest. Okay, so I already told to you, if you are using any algorithm, they have both classifier type of algorithm and regression type of algorithm. See here, here I'm having a classifier, random forest classifier, and random forest regression. Okay, we got two different algorithms. Okay, but here I'm using a regression type of algorithm, so I am using regression. Okay, so after this, I just convert my algorithm into one variable, and a function into then I am training my algorithm. If you want to train the algorithm, you need to use fit. Fit is the function to train the algorithm. In this, I am just passing my train data and y train data. Okay, that is data and data of that output I am just passing. After the I am passing, I am just finding the accuracy result of my accuracy score of my test data. That is, I am passing a test data and finding the accuracy result y test. Here you can see 90%. So 90% algorithm will understand of your data. Okay, 90% is predicting the correctly. Okay, so we are just checking the what is that? We are seeing just 90%. Okay, we need to see in graphical manner. Okay, whether it's predicting correctly or not. Okay, so for that purpose, I am using a plot. Okay, plotting graph. Okay, before that, I am creating one variable. Okay, so in this variable, I am passing RF dot predict function. Okay, so my prediction result of algorithm will be stored in this RF predict. So I need to compare this algorithm result, that is RF predict is the algorithm output and Y test is my data set output. Okay, I need to compare this. If we comparing time, what you will be getting on output, that is called 90%. Okay, so here I am plotting the graph, that is PLT dot plot. Okay, so PLT is nothing but plotting a graph, then Y test, and then color. So color you can give anything. Okay, for example, here I am giving blue color, blue. Okay, then after that, label I am giving. Label is nothing but just what is the x axis, what is the y axis, like that I want to show. So for that purpose, I am using label equal to, first I am passing my actual output, that is in data set what is my output, I am just passing the actual output, that is actual values in my data set, and then same code only for next line also, just copying and then plotting. Then next I am plotting that prediction value. Okay, prediction value is algorithm given on output, now that output and my original output I want to compare. So for that purpose, I am using a predicted value. The predicted value should be in the form of red color. Okay, then instead of here white test, I need to use RF predict, that is random forest predict. Okay, so after predicting, I just giving a label, label of the x-axis, that is sorry, y label. Here I am passing the mean temperature. Mean temp, and then plot. Here I am plotting the graph. Okay, so if I run the cell, you will be get an output. See here. So blue color is my original output in my data set, and then red color is my algorithm predict, that is random forest algorithm predicted output, that will be stored in red color, as a red color. So here you can see it's almost predicted correctly only, okay, compared to previous one, and sorry, compared to the data set, and then algorithm predictor is seems to be an looking equal only, okay. So that is what I'm getting here result, 90% accuracy result, okay. So 90% accuracy result means 90% it's predicted properly according to the data set, okay. So this is what I want to tell you about, guys, today, in this today's session, how we can plot forecasting using machine learning, okay. So I hope everyone will understood about this webinar, okay. So if you have any doubt regarding this webinar, please put it in comment box, sorry comment box, not chat box, okay. I will explain. If you have any doubt regarding this session, or if you have anything, you can just put it in comment box, I will explain to you, okay. So let's reopen chat box. So any doubt you can just ask to me. If you have any doubt, you can ask in comment chat box, I will reply you. So there is no doubt. Anybody? Okay. So next I want to tell about, we are providing an intensive online internship like this, Internet of Things, Python programming language, machine learning, NLP, AI, blockchain. Okay. So if you are willing to participate those internship, you can contact us, okay. So thank you for this today's session. If you have any doubt regarding this webinar, you can contact me on hyd.java@pantechmail.com. If you want to know about further upcoming events, like we are providing a daily webinar on YouTube, if you want to see those webinars in YouTube, you can subscribe to our channel, the Pantech e-learning. And then if you are want to any queries, you want upcoming event, you can WhatsApp this number, we will help you. And then we have a channel in Telegram also, Pantech e-learning, you can contact those thing, okay. So if you want to register for any internship, you can this three numbers, Mr. Sanjeev Kumar, Mr. Srinivasan, and Mr. Kumar Asan. Okay.
Hello. Sir, there is a doubt asked by the student.
Okay.
Hello?
Wait a minute.
You are able to hear me?
Yes, yes.
Hello. How can I use machine language algorithm in speech enhancement? There is a question, a doubt raised by the student.
Okay, ma'am. One second, repeat.
By Ankita Chakrabarti.
Speech enhancement.
Speech enhancement.
Yes, actually, we have a different type of package, okay. For example, if your data set in the form of a text file, we need to use NLP, natural language processing, or natural language toolkit, okay. So like this, if you want to use speech type, if you want to train the speech type of data set, means you need to use GTTS, okay. This is the one of the package for Python. Okay.
The speech trainer.
We need to convert those audio into an machine readable. Then after that, we need to train.
We send separately. Yeah.
Okay. So for that purpose, we need to use.
Hello.
Any other doubt?
Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
So very informative sessions, or I'm doing research of speech and okay
sir, thank you. So this is end of the session. On there are no other further doubts raised by the students, so we'll end up the session. Okay, it's now time for the vote of thanks. So I feel happy to express our sincere thanks to the presenter today for his nice presentation. I hope that everybody would have found it useful. I thank the management, principal and EC department for having successfully hosted today's webinar session. And I thank the participants for their presence and cooperation. I hope the students would have benefited. Then feedback form will be sent to you. So for the participants, and e-certificate will be provided to all the participants today. I thank once again all the participants. So thank you once again.
I am very glad to take a webinar to this CRISP college. Thank you for this wonderful opportunity.
That's in the chat. So it will be sent. Yeah. So it will be sent to their personal mail IDs. Okay. Thank you. Thank you all once again. Thank you.